What is styrofoam? Styrofoam is a kind of plastic you can see everyday life, from food packaging like the ones I have to medical packages. The word styrofoam is a trademark name for those chemical form insulation product. It's a type of plastic known as polyethylene or plastic number 6. Polyethylene is a petroleum-based material that is hard plastic used for products like medical products or more. It can also be made into a form as known as expanded polyethylene. Expanded polyethylene products are styrofoam. These products include food containers, product packaging. The word EPS, which polyethylene form, is the same product as the styrofoam, as you see in other places. The greenhouse effect is a major issue of climate change. The process of manufacturing styrofoam will release a huge amount of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. For every styrofoam manufactured, 0.07229 pounds of carbon dioxide is released into the atmosphere. The United States produces about 3 million tons of styrofoam every year. So approximately 21 million tons of carbon dioxide are released into the atmosphere every year. According to Stanford News, the social cost of carbon is $220 per ton. Therefore, the social cost of greenhouse gas emissions from the production of styrofoam is estimated at approximately $4.6 billion per year. However, even the FDA approves polyethylene in the use of food containers. Furthermore, it clearly defines the threshold level of polyethylene in the final product that comes in contact with the food in environmental regulation titles, which indicates that even with highest level of polyethylene containers, they're still not qualified to be in the fully stage at all. EPS is made of serious chemical reactions starting from benzene. It's a derivative from petroleum. When we're producing EPS, the first step is not qualified to UNSDG 12. First, benzene is react with ethylene to form styrene. Styrene is a chemical polymerized to include polyethylene. In the making of EPS, the steam is then used to release the gas, resulting in an impact to environments. And furthermore, the EPS is not degradable at all. The Department of Health and Human Services International Agency of Cancer Research and EPA has determined that benzene is carcinogenic to humans, with a longer-term exposure of cause increasing the risk of leukemia. The best and simplest way to prevent the damage is simply not using polyethylene. However, nowadays, more and more companies are offering more environmental-friendly alternatives like styrofoam into their products, such as air packets. These kinds of products are more environmental-friendly than styrofoam, very lightweight, take up less space before and after use. Other alternatives are biodegradable food packaging, cups, plates, and more like scratched corn scratch or paper.